So let's talk about how to determine a vitamin C deficiency, a major vitamin C deficiency, like a subclinical scurvy type situation, just from looking at the tongue. So the name of this would be scorbutic tongue. So you have a combination of glossitis, which is a condition where the tongue is inflamed, kind of shiny, sometimes red, with red blotches on the side through here. And that's basically a very tiny micro hemorrhaging of the blood vessels. And you can also see that in other parts of the body, like the lower legs, where there's these red purple spots. And the reason for that is vitamin C is intimately involved in making collagen, and it's involved in connective tissue. So the inside of your vascular system is all connective tissue. So if you don't have enough vitamin C to make that network, everything falls apart, and you start getting little areas of bruising and bleeding and little red spots and blotches, and it can happen in the tongue, anywhere in the body. And so there's other vitamin C deficiencies as well. But realize a vitamin C deficiency starts off very, very gradual, and the more deficient you are, the more symptoms you're going to have. You don't want to necessarily wait until you have all of these symptoms to do something about it, but it does usually take about a month of not consuming vitamin C to have this show up. And there's other things too that can create a deficiency by preventing the absorption of vitamin C. So you may be consuming vitamin C or even taking it as a supplement, but if you're consuming this thing called sugar, or you have high levels of sugar in your bloodstream because you're diabetic, that can block your vitamin C levels. Why? Because the chemistry of vitamin C is very similar to sugar. So if you consume them at the same time, the sugar is going to go in and the vitamin C will not. So if you're going to consume sugar, consume it not when you're taking the vitamin C at a different time period. And I'm being very sarcastic because you don't want to consume any sugar at all. There are many other symptoms of a vitamin C deficiency. One would be fatigue. And that's probably going to be the first one you experience. You have this lethargy, you're weak, you're tired. You may develop sore arms or legs. You might brush your teeth and notice there's blood on there, bleeding gums. Why? Because of connective tissue or collagen around the vascular part of your gums. Also, you can experience bone pain. You can also see this with a vitamin D deficiency. Bruising, like we just talked about, the vascular system, and then these red and purple spots. A lot of times you'll see them in the lower legs, especially in a diabetic. I wonder why. Because sugar competes for vitamin C and they have high levels of sugar. Also, because vitamin C is necessary to strengthen collagen, tendons, ligaments, you may find that your teeth are loose. Here's some good foods that have higher levels of vitamin C. Citrus, like lemon juice, but it has to be raw because heat destroys it. Peppers, red peppers, green peppers. Sauerkraut probably has the most vitamin C. If you have a good sauerkraut, you're talking like 700 milligrams of vitamin C per cup. I mean, our RDAs for vitamin C is about 90. So you're consuming a tremendous amount of vitamin C when you do sauerkraut. The leafy greens, salads, Brussels sprouts, broccoli all have vitamin C. Parsley is loaded with vitamin C, and so is cabbage, which, well, that's how you make the sauerkraut, right? So there you have it. If you want more information about vitamin C, I put the video up right here that you need to watch next.